So, Jai Hind to all. Today, we are going to cover a very important topic of subject microprocessor and microcontroller, that is 8051 microcontroller. We have already discussed in previous lectures about microprocessor. Now, we move towards microcontroller, which is the heart of any embedded system. Regarding microprocessor, microprocessor is a general purpose system which contains various registers, control unit, ALU, timing and control section, interrupts and serial communication ports. But the memory, that is RAM, ROM and peripherals, as well as timer devices, are connected from outside microprocessor to make it work as a complete system. Whereas microcontroller is a complete system on a single chip, that is it consists of CPU, that is microprocessor, plus memory, that is RAM, ROM, timer, peripherals and all other devices required to make it as a complete system. So, as we can see from this block diagram, that a system consisting of microprocessor consists of RAM, ROM, IO devices, timer and serial communication ports outside the microprocessor. Whereas system consisting of microcontroller consists of CPU, RAM, ROM, IO, timer and serial communication ports all embedded on a single chip. So that's why it is also called as a system on a single chip or embedded microprocessor. So as we have already discussed regarding microprocessor, that it is a general purpose device, that is we can perform any type of application using microprocessor. But to make a device out of microprocessor, we should add some memory, that is RAM, ROM, IO ports, timers and interrupt controllers plus some other devices externally, which make the system bulkier and much more expensive. But it also adds the advantage of versatility, that is the systems or computers or processors or mobile phones are microprocessor based systems. That is, we can perform any type of application, like we can listen to audio, video, we can use it for academic like Word or Excel purposes, or we can do some kind of coding also. Means a system consisting of microprocessor has versatile range of applications. Now moving towards microcontroller, since all the memories, IOs are on the same chip, so only a fixed amount of on-chip ROM, RAM, IOs are added to the microprocessor to make it work as a complete system. And basically, this makes it applicable for several applications in which cost and space are critical issue. So, in many applications, the space, power consumption, cost of hardware, that is price per unit, are much more important than the range of applications. For example, if we have to design any controller for a washing machine, then it should be of smaller size, less cost and consume lesser power. So it should be designed using microcontroller because it has a only single purpose to control the working of washing machine. And so, no need of versatility required. So, an embedded product uses a microprocessor or microcontroller. But if we talk about microprocessor based system, it can perform multiple range of tasks. But if we talk about microcontroller system, it is designed for a single and specific task. So, a PC or a personal computer, in contrast to microcontroller based system, can be used for a range of applications, but the RAM, ROM and other IOs are connected externally. So now we can say that microcontroller based system, due to its limited cost, limited size and less power consumption, can be used for a range of applications which are domestic or in offices or automatic systems. like intercoms, telephone, computer, TV, remote control, cellular phones, and we can say, think of any electronic device nowadays, it consists of one or the other form of microcontroller. So now we start with the range of microcontrollers. In this video, we will study 8051 microcontroller family, which is a 8-bit microcontroller. It is the most important one because 8-bit can be used for a range of applications, and a large number of 8-bit microcontrollers are available in the market, starting from Motorola 6811, Intel 8051, Zilog 78, and Microchips PIC. There are also 16-bit and 32-bit microcontrollers available, but we will restrict our study to 8-bit because of cost and limited requirements. So when we talk about 8051, it is a 8-bit microcontroller. That is, the CPU can work only on 8-bit data at a time. 8051 had 128 bytes of RAM, 4 kilobyte of on-chip ROM, 2 timers, 1 serial port, 4 IO ports if each 8-bit wide from P0 to P3, and 6 interrupt sources. 8051 consists of on-chip ROM for coding, on-chip RAM, timer, 2 timers, timer 0, timer 1, 1 serial port with transmit data and receive data signals, I/O ports P0, P1, P2, P3 each of 8-bit to receive or transmit data, bus controller, oscillator to give the frequency, which is around 12 MHz, CPU which performs the operation, and interrupt control unit which routes the external interrupt. So this is the overall block diagram of our 8051 microcontroller. When we talk about 8051 family, it consists of three 8051 microcontrollers of 8-bit, 8051, 8052, and 8031. All are of similar pattern, but there is a small difference between memory, timer, I/O pins, and ports. So if we talk about on-chip ROM, 8051 consists of 4 kilobyte of RAM. ROM 8052 consists of 8 kilobytes of on-chip program space, whereas 8031 does not contain on-chip ROM. That is, we can say that 8031 is a ROM-less 8051. Now we talk about RAM. 8051 consists of 128 bytes of RAM. Similarly, 8031 also contains 128 bytes, where 8052 consists of 256 bytes of RAM. Both 8051 and 31 consists of 2 timers, whereas 8052 consists of 3 timers. Each of these microcontrollers consists of 32 I/O pins, that is 4 ports each of 8-bit. Each one has one serial port, and 8051 and 8031 have 6 interrupts, whereas 8052 has 8 external interrupts. So before moving further, we want to know about the program status word and flag bits. So we have already studied about flag register in 8085 and 8086 microprocessor. Flag register shows the status of any operation performed by ALU. The same thing is done by program status word, that is PSW, in case of 8051. It is also an 8-bit register which consists of 6 flags: carry, auxiliary carry, parity, overflow, and 2, that is I0, PSW3 and 4, that is RS0 and IRS1, to select one of 4 register banks. 2 bits are not used here. So out of 8, only 6 bits are used to show the status. So this is the complete PSW program status word. Starting from PSW7, it is a carry flag. When the carry is generated from MSB, then carry flag is 1, else 0. Next is auxiliary carry. when a carry is generated from lower nibble to higher nibble, that is D3 to D4, then auxiliary carry will be 1. F0 is blank, that is used for general purpose. RS1, RS0. This is the register select bits, which is used to select one out of 4 register bank. There are 4 register banks. For RS1 00, it is register bank 0, 01 then to select register bank 1, 10 to select register bank 2, and 11 to select register bank 3. Also, the address range of each register bank starts from each of 8 bit. So, 00 to 07, 08 to 0F, 10 to 17, and 18 to 1F. Next is OV overflow flag. Overflow flag results in signed number only. For signed numbers, MSB is reserved for signed bit. So, when there is a carry generated from D6, then only overflow flag will be 1. And last is the P, that is parity flag. Parity flag is used to show even number of 1s or odd number of 1s in data. If there is an even number of 1, parity flag will be 0. And for odd number of 1s, parity flag will be 1. So, we will see some examples. From this, the value of each flag will be clear. So, this is the operation of add. And we have to find the carry, auxiliary carry and parity flag after the addition of 38 and 2F. So, this is the program. Move A38, A2F, add. So, we have already learned about the addition. So, the addition of these two numbers, F is 15 plus 8, 23. 23 is greater than 16. So, we will subtract it from 16. 23 minus 16, 7. And 1 carry. So, 3, 4 to 6. 67 is the result. We will open this value 0110 and 0111. This is the result. As we can see that the carry is generated from lower nibble to higher nibble. So, auxiliary carry flag will be 1. Since there is no carry from upper nibble, so carry flag will be 0. And since the number of 1s in data is odd, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so parity flag will be 1. So, in this way, we calculate the result, that is carry 0, auxiliary carry 1 and parity flag 1 after addition operation. We will take one more example, like add 9C and 64. From this data, CA is 12, 12 plus 4, 16, 16 minus 16, that is 0 and 1 carry. Then 9, 8, 10 and 6, 16. So, 16 minus 16, 0 and 1 carry. So, we can see from this example that both carry and auxiliary carry will be 1. And since the data consists of all zeros, so parity flag will be 0. Since 0 is not an odd number. We will take one more example of addition of 88 and 93. The result will be 8 plus 3, 11, that is B, and 9 plus 8, 17, minus 16, 1. The 1B is the data and 1 is the carry flag. Since no carry is moved from here to here, so auxiliary carry 0. A carry is generated from MSB, so carry flag 1. And the result consists of 1B, that is 0001. And B, that is 8 to 10, 11. So, even number of 1s, so parity flag 0. So, in this way, we find out the value of flag, that is program flags. Now, we move towards the register bank and stack. As we know that 8051 consists of 128 bytes of RAM. This address ranges from 00 to 7F. Out this 128 byte is divided into 3 different groups. The first one is from 00 to 1F consists of 32 bytes. which is set aside for register banks. It consists of four register banks of R0 to R7, that is 8 registers, and there are each bank consists of 8 registers, so 32 bytes. So it consists of four register bank, bank 0, 1, 2, 3. Each consists of 8 bytes. So there are total 32 bytes ranging from 00 to 1F. Next is a total of 16 bytes ranging from 20 to 2F, which consists of bit addressable memory. These are called as working registers. And this is called as bit addressable read-write memory. And the remaining, that is 80 bytes, that is from 30 to 7F, are used for read and write high-speed data, also called as scratch pad. That is a spatial high-speed memory used to hold a small data for rapid retrieval. Now, we can see this in the form of range from 00 to 07 register bank 0, then 8 to 15 register bank 1, also called as a stack area, from 10 to 17 register bank 2, and 18 to 1F register bank 3. So these are the working registers. After this, from 20 to 2F, it is bit addressable RAM. That is, we can add or edit each bit. For example, set B to 5 will edit the data from 25 location. This is the address 20 to 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 to 5. And we'll edit this bit only. So in this way, it's edit a single bit. And last is the 30 to 7F, that is 80 bytes of scratch pad RAM. So this 32 bytes are divided into four banks of registers, and each bank consists of R0s to R7, that is 8 registers. So RAM location 0 to 7 are assigned for bank 0. RAM location 8 to 15 are assigned for bank 1. Sixteen to 23 assigned for bank 3. And 23 to 31 assigned for bank 4. We can see this in this register bank diagram. For example, bank 0 has 0 to 7, or precisely 0, 0 to 0, 7. The registers are named R0, R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, R7. The name of register is same, only the bank will be changed. So, 8 to F is bank 1, 10 to 17 bank 2, and 18 to 15F are bank 3. So, the same register R2 can have different addresses with respect to each bank. For example, R2 register of bank 0 has address 02. Whereas R2 register of bank 1 has address 0A, R2 register of bank 2 has address 12, and R2 register of bank 3 has 1A. So, first of all, before selecting any register, we have to select the bank. For this purpose, we use the RS1 and RS0 pins of program status 1. When this value is 00, bank 0 is selected. When this value is 01, bank 1 is selected. With 10, bank 2. And with 11, bank 3 is selected, as we have already seen this in program status 1. So, we can switch from one bank to another bank by using PSW3 and PSW4 bits. And we can use the set bit and clear bit to access these values. We have already seen in previous slide that when PSW4 and PSW3 are 00, bank 0 is selected, and similarly when 11, bank 3 will be selected. Now we can say a small example to see what the instructions are doing. For example, in the very first case, 99 hash symbol is used to indicate data. So 99 data is transferred to register R0. Similarly, in second case, 85 data is loaded to register R1. In next example, 00 and 01 are the address of registers. So 00 means the R0 of bank 0. 99 data is moved to R0 of bank 0. Similarly, 85 is moved to R1 of bank 0. That is 01 location. And in third, we can see that we can select the bank by setting and clear PSW 3 and 4. So let we have set PSB PSW 4 means PSW 1. 4 is equal to 1 means we have selected 10 location, that is bank 2. So move R0 hash 99. So 99 data is moved to register R0 of bank 2 means the location is 10. So, move data 99 to 10. Similarly, move data R85 to R1 of bank 2, which is 11 location with data is transferred 85. So, in this way, various banks and addresses and data is given in instructions of 8051. Now we move towards a very important area, that is stack area in case of 8051. Stack is a separate section of RAM which is used to store information temporarily. This information can be data or address. And the register which is used to access stack is called as stack pointer. And in case of 8051, it is of 8 bit. Whereas in 8085 or 8086, this register is of 16 bit. So the address range of stack pointer can take value from 00 to FF. When the 8051 is reset and powered up, the SP by default value will be 07. That is the first location where the data can be written in stack is the 08 location. To store a data, we use push instruction, and to read out a data, we use pop operation. This is just the opposite in case of 8085. To push a data onto stack, SP is incremented by 1, whereas to pop a data from stack, SP is decremented by 1, which is just the opposite with respect to microprocessors. We have to make it understand. For example, if we consider this instruction to move data 25 to R6, then 12 to R1 and F3 to R4, then push 6. Let stack pointer is started from reset, to SP is 07. So the first blank location is 08. After push 6, the value of R6 is pushed to 08, so 25 is put to 08 location. Next push 1, so 12 is put to 09 location. And then push 4, that is F3, is pushed to 0A location. So now the stack pointer will move to 0A. We'll take one more example of pop operation. Let the stack pointer is 0B and these are the content of stack memory. So after pop 3, the content of stack pointer is moved to R3 location. That is 54 is moved to R3. Next, pop 5, so F9 that is moved to R5. And last, pop 2, so 76 is moved to R2. And now the stack pointer is updated to 08. So this is the value of R3, R5 and R2. R3 will consist of 54, then F9 and then 76, as we can see from this example. We will take, this is another similar example, that is move, copy the value of 5F, so stack pointer will become 5F. Then push 2 will copy the content of R2, that is 25 to 5F plus 1, that is 60 location. Then push 1 will copy 12 to 61 location. and push 4 will copy F3 to 62 location. So now the stack pointer will become 62. So in this way, 8051 works. Now the next topic, that is pin diagram of 8051, it is a 40 pin IC and consists of 4 8-bit ports P0, P1, P2 and P3. And we will continue this pin diagram to and its operating modes plus addressing modes in next lectures. Thank you all.